Let's go to the next para. So here, now Swami Vivekananda will say that death is going to haunt us. The idea of happiness, in the first two paragraphs, he said that death is going to haunt you and going to ask, is this real? And then we believe in reality of our existence right now. Happiness is the purpose of life. And we see that happiness also eludes us and we really aren't going to be fulfilled and happy all the time. When we reach such a state, we might perceive things to be extremely negative in nature and extremely cynical. We might be skeptic. Skeptic is a person who always doubts everything about the reality of existence, because when his ideas about life get shattered owing to some strong trauma or some strong reaction in life like death or disease or betrayal, he becomes extremely skeptic. So these are the times when man understands this, that he takes to some path to give him a sort of freedom. We should understand that nobody jumps into religion for the sake of spirituality. Religions that we jump into when we are not seeking answers for this is not religion at all. It is a cultural setup where our traditions are kept alive. That is also a very good function of religion. Religion keeps our culture alive by reviving the traditions and reliving the traditions, and that gives a good identity to man. Most of us follow religion from that perspective, but we are not talking of that religion what man seeks. If we have to speak of religion, religion is to take man to spirituality. People mix the cultural and the traditional function of religion with the spiritual function of religion. Whenever we say religion in terms of studying spirituality, we mean that mechanism which is going to prepare man for spiritual life. So here in the context of religion, when I say, I mean that mechanism which is going to prepare him for the higher life of inquiry. So when man goes through these kind of situations, he is pushed to find answers for this. This is when he takes to two paths. It depends on his nature of how his mind is and how he has been cultured. Swami Vivekananda says that two positions remain before mankind when he reaches this kind of thing, that death is inevitable and happiness is never going to be had. You become a skeptic, or you run to some religious institution and try to find meaning of life there. So I'll read out what he says. Two positions remain to mankind. One is to believe with the nihilists that all is nothing, that we know nothing, that we can never know anything either about the future, the past, or even the present. For we must remember that he who denies the past and the future and wants to stick to the present is simply a madman. One may as well deny the father and mother and assert the child. It would be equally logical. To deny the past and the future, the present must inevitably be denied also. This is one position, that of the nihilists. I have never seen a man who could really become a nihilist for 1 minute. It is very easy to talk. He has spoken a few lines about the nihilists, but instead of going into each line, I would just try to tell you what Swami Vivekananda is trying to tell here, is that one view is skepticism after life betrays us in terms of the happiness that we think, and in terms of the fact that the life is going to be snatched at any moment. We become skeptical, and when we become skeptical, we become unsure of everything and we start doubting everything. This is a phase in spiritual growth. And he says that this phase is one option that is left to mankind. The nihilist. Nihilism is a state of mind. I know there are many followers of nihilist philosophy and who believe in them. But when we in Vedanta speak of nihilism, we say that it is a state of mind. And one has to go through the state of mind where one really doubts everything. But the danger of nihilism is that when you deny everything, you deny your present existence. And when you deny your present existence, you go into a state of being psychologically handicapped. And when you do that, you lose a sense of life, love, and purpose. And that is why nihilism is extremely dangerous if you do not go to search for these answers to a proper person who can guide you through life to get these answers. Nihilism is skepticism shown towards everything, skepticism shown towards the moral culture, towards our tradition. It doubts everything. Why should we have morality? I don't think morality is the basis of life. Why should we have religion? I don't think religion is the basis of life. Why should we have science? Science could be cheating us. Everything in science need not be taken as true. We could disapprove. It is a right point. It is a point where we do not take everything to its absolute sense. But the danger is, if we deny the good things about life, morality, religion, ethics, sociology, science, we might become physically, psychologically handicapped, and we might feel a sense of dread and dryness within us. So he says that when you follow nihilism, you have to follow it to such a level that you deny anything of the reality of the past, because past is only in the mind, future is never come ahead, so you do not even think about the future. And therefore, he says, if you do not take into account these two, you even deny the present. Though you're living in the present, you are not fully living in it. You even end up denying the present. He says that it's very easy to talk of this philosophy because everything makes a lot of sense, but it is very difficult to live by. And he says it is very easy to talk. I have not seen a single person become a nihilist for more than 1 minute. It is because you end up living in this world of what we call existence, sat, where there is reality. And to deny reality in the cosmos is to deny yourself, and no man has ever denied himself. And where we have denied ourselves, we have seen that we have gone into a state of broken sense of identity, where trauma remains in a manner that makes us incapable of living, communicating, and loving in this world. So he says nihilism is one point. It may seem extremely logical. And there's another point which he talks of, and this is religion. So in the next podcast, I will take up the idea of religion that man takes, and let us see if Swami Vivekananda is going to be skeptical about religion as well, or what is his take on religion. We'll see how he presents religion and its impact on the mind, and does it have any basis of truth. We can be extremely comfortable with the idea that Swami Vivekananda is going to be extremely objective and place facts as they are. He is inclined towards religion, but not the religion that sticks to tradition and culture, while it is good for civilization. He agrees with religion wherever religion shines a certain amount of truth. Nihilism also shines on a certain amount of truth, that we can not be sure of this existence, but that doesn't mean we become skeptics and cynics. There is a way to be unsure of this universe, yet have love and happiness in our heart, and love and happiness and welfare for the rest of humanity. There is a way. So he denies nihilism in the sense that it is not complete. We shall see what he speaks about religion in the next chapter, and presents the advantages and the disadvantages of using religion to solve the problem of what is real, understanding death, and trying to seek happiness. So till the next podcast, thanks. Thank you for listening.